LA County health officials revealed today they are investigating a case of measles involving a resident who recently traveled from Texas. This as an outbreak in West Texas has now surged to nearly 650 cases. Concerns growing that the viral infection could become endemic in the coming years if vaccination rates don't change.
With more, we're joined once again by Dr. Anne Rimoin, professor of epidemiology at the UCLA Fielding School of Public Health. Dr. Anne, always good to have you. Starting here with that outbreak in West Texas, you were on with us in February, and that outbreak then was at less than 150 cases. Now we're seeing cases in 29 states. Where does this outbreak stand?
Well, thanks for having me, and this is a very important topic. We're starting to see the spread of measles, which doesn't respect state lines, doesn't respect boundaries. You know, an infection anywhere is potentially an infection everywhere, and especially with measles, because this is a very contagious virus. It is the most contagious virus that we know of, and it can linger in the air for up to 2 hours after someone who is infectious leaves the room. So we've now seen a case reported here in Los Angeles. We've had a case come through LAX. We're seeing it in 29 states, so we can expect this to continue. The only way to be able to reduce this spread, to stop it, is really to make sure that we have vaccination rates as high as possible. 95% of the population needs to be vaccinated to have what we call herd immunity, to really stop it in its tracks.
So let's talk a little bit more about that in depth. All of this as new research from Stanford forecasts that measles could become endemic again, with more than 850,000 cases over the next 25 years if vaccination rates don't change. Where are we with vaccinations, and how much would things need to change to avoid that future?
You know, measles was eliminated from the United States in 2000. That means that the virus was no longer spreading inside this country for any extended period of time. So this is a really important moment that we're starting to see the potential for this to become endemic in the population again. And as I mentioned, you really need to have high rates of vaccination, up to 95% of the population vaccinated, to really achieve that. So the thing that we need to make sure is that as many people as possible get vaccinated, because this will spread. And so I'd like to remind people that if you were born between 1957 and around 1997, you really ought to make sure that you had at least two doses, or had at least one dose of the MMR vaccine. And if not, and if you're going to be traveling, make sure that you get a booster of it as well. It could be very important. Just to make sure that you're paying attention, and if you're traveling to areas where, in particular, if there may be cases.
All right, let's change track. We understand doctors bracing for a tough year in regards to whooping cough. 8,500 cases already reported by the CDC this year, twice as many as this point last year. What, in your view, is behind the surge, and is it cause for concern?
Well, pertussis, or whooping cough, is cyclical. So we do see these cases crescendo over time, but we are seeing this trend happen over and over again. And this is probably also related to the fact that we're seeing a dip in vaccination rates. This is a virus that is also very, very well controlled with high rates of vaccination, and we are seeing rates of vaccination drop everywhere.
Let's talk rabies. This week, Orange County health officials reported a bat had tested positive for rabies. Human cases of rabies are extremely rare, as we know, but how can viewers and their pets avoid becoming the exception?
Well, it's important for people to know that rabies is actually endemic here in California and in Southern California in wildlife, and most often found in bats. So it's very important to make sure that you do not touch wildlife, in particular wildlife that is sick. I would definitely avoid coming in close contact with bats. Make sure your pets are vaccinated. And if you see an animal that's acting strangely, make sure to call animal control or Fish and Wildlife.
Always good information. Always good to have you. Dr. Anne Rimoin, thanks for being on with us.
My pleasure.